Hello all, in this video we'll talk about DPC++. My name is Abhishek Nandi, I am Intel Software Innovator. So why should I use DPC++? Today each type of hardware, be it CPU, GPU, FPGA and specialized accelerator, requires a unique programming approach using different tools and libraries. For developers, it becomes very difficult to maintain different code bases and tools. So in that case, it results in inefficiencies, complexities, and additional programming overhead. During different codes, we have to put it in different hardwares, and it is very impractical. So DPC++ solves the problem. It is a way how we simplify heterogeneous programming. What it gets me? DPC++ is a standard-based cross-architecture language and open community-based project. It's based on C++ and supports SQL from the Kronos group to support data parallelism and heterogeneous programming. New extension funded by the collaboration on open source community which will extend the parallelism also it would increase the productivity and bring additional capabilities. DPC++ is compatible with programming languages such as C, Fortran and Python. It supports parallel modules such as OpenMP and MPI. The kernel-based programming style that DPC++ inherits from SQL, well versed with application developers, and they can get started very easily. DPC++ is built to provide native high-level language performance, unlike managed runtimes, across architectural solution. It allows code reuse across hardware targets. Now let's see a small demo where we will see the ease of use of DPC++. So we have installed the OneAPI base toolkit. So in the Visual Studio 2017, if you have installed the OneAPI base toolkit, you will see an extension called Intel at the top. You need to just click on that and then click on Create New Intel OneAPI Project. So now you will see the listings. Here you see DPC++. We'll start with a Hello World application. It's a console application that we are going to start with. And with this, if I just click OK, the code base for application would come up automatically. So you see how easy it is to get started with DPC++. And what exactly this demo does is that if you have an accelerator that you are using, it would search for it and also give show it, like this is the particular accelerator that you are using as for your graphics itself. So to run this application, what you need to do is you need to hit this local Windows debugger, and you will see that the command line utility will show you the output because it's a console based application that we are working on. So we have just hit the local Windows debugger, and in the output option you'll see the build process. It's debugging for x64, and you just wait for a while to see the output that is being created. Now here also see this is the build is started. So now you will see that the application is running. So your device is Intel R registered ultra high definition graphics 620, and it's success. So that's the way how easily you can get started with DPC++. And the one most important part is already the code base is there. You can build on top of that. Thank you.